Shalom and good evening. This is TV7 Israel News, broadcasting to you from Jerusalem. And in today's top stories, Palestinian Prime Minister Rami Hamdallah declares reconciliation between the rival Palestinian factions, Fatah and Hamas, as a vital component for the establishment of a Palestinian state. Washington, as part of its efforts to restart the long-stalled peace process between Israel and the Palestinians, calls on the Palestinian leadership to immediately commit to nonviolence, accept previous agreements and obligations, and fully recognize the State of Israel. Mossad Director Yossi Cohen declares his intelligence agency continues to focus on the aggressive conduct of the Islamic Republic of Iran, including its regional aspirations and the ongoing pursuit of the regime in Tehran to achieve nuclear weapons capabilities. In what was declared as a major step toward Palestinian reconciliation between the West Bank-based Fatah and Gaza-based Hamas, the latter announced last week that it was handing over administrative control of the Gaza Strip to the unity government headed by Palestinian Prime Minister Rami Hamdallah. Following Hamas's announcement, a senior Palestinian delegation arrived in the Gaza Strip yesterday to coordinate the transfer of power, and a move the Palestinian Prime Minister declared was a vital component for the establishment of a Palestinian state. The transfer of Hamas's administrative powers in Gaza to the Palestinian Unity Government was warmly welcomed by the international community, which views the move as a stepping stone toward humanitarian relief.
I expect that within the next few days, as the government begins to take up its responsibilities in Gaza, we will see some of the humanitarian problems in Gaza resolved quickly.
While Hamas declares its decision to hand over administrative control as a strategic move, Palestinian officials in the West Bank told TV7 that the growing isolation of Hamas was the key ingredient to the latest developments. The officials pointed to the significant blows Hamas's umbrella organization, the Muslim Brotherhood, has suffered in recent years, as well as the ongoing blockade imposed by regional powers on Qatar, Hamas's main financial backer. The final blow that forced the Hamas leadership to relinquish control of its administrative powers came after Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas decided to stop paying Israel for electricity it provides the Palestinian enclave, a move that has elevated pressure on the densely populated Gaza Strip due to a rapidly deteriorating humanitarian situation. Now that Hamas has agreed, however, to relinquish its administrative control in the Gaza Strip to President Mahmoud Abbas's Palestinian Authority, the Palestinian leadership hopes to counter Israel's argument that it has no negotiating partner for peace. Nevertheless, Israeli officials do not seem impressed by the Palestinian reconciliation bid, stressing that such attempts happen every 2 or 3 years.
Well, the Palestinian Authority and Hamas every several years try to hold unity talks. They never amount to anything. They almost invariably break down, and that's probably what's going to happen this time as well.
Deputy Minister Michael Oren stressed that while Israel continues to aspire for true and lasting peace with all of its Arab neighbors, including the Palestinians, the Jewish state cannot take serious Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas's attempts to reconcile with a terrorist organization that seeks Israel's destruction.
Israel wants peace with all of our Arab neighbors, including the Palestinians. If Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas truly wants peace with the State of Israel, he will not be directing his energies toward the terrorists of Hamas, but he will cease educating his young people to hate and murder Israeli Jews, and Abbas will return to negotiating tables after 8 years in which he has refused to do so.
Professor Hillel Frisch, an Israeli Middle East analyst who closely monitors the ongoing attempts by the Palestinian rival factions to seek reconciliation, pointed to a demand by Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas in which Hamas would relinquish its weapons to the Palestinian Authority security establishment, a demand vehemently rejected by the Islamist group in Gaza. Professor Frisch further stressed that unless Hamas agrees to relinquish its weapons to the Palestinian Authority, the unity deal would be perceived as meaningless by Israel.
For Israel, there's only one meaning. If the PA succeeds in militarily subduing Hamas or bringing about its dismantling and demilitarization. If that doesn't succeed, and it probably won't, then these talks are meaningless for Israel. There are five issues on the table, but the most important issue isn't. Who controls the guns in Gaza? And it's apparent that Hamas refuses to dismantle its security forces.
Now to a related matter, U.S. President Donald Trump's special envoy to the Middle East, Jason Greenblatt, published on his Twitter page a call on the Palestinian leadership to immediately commit to nonviolence, accept previous agreements and obligations, and fully recognize the State of Israel. The envoy's tweet read, "The United States stresses that any Palestinian government must unambiguously and explicitly commit to nonviolence, recognition of the State of Israel, acceptance of previous agreements and obligations between the parties, and peaceful negotiations. With regard to the ongoing attempt to seek reconciliation between Fatah and Hamas, Trump's envoy stated that the United States welcomes efforts to create the conditions for the Palestinian Authority to fully assume its responsibilities in Gaza." Now to Jerusalem, where Mossad Director Yossi Cohen, in a special ceremony at the Prime Minister's residence in Jerusalem, declared that the Mossad's key objectives continue to focus on the aggressive conduct of the Islamic Republic of Iran, including its regional aspirations and the ongoing pursuit of the regime in Tehran to achieve nuclear weapons capabilities.
איראן ממשיכה לאחוז בחזונה, לקיים יכולת גרעינית משמעותית, כדי שזאת תוביל ליכולת גרעינית צבאית. איראן ממשיכה להפעיל באגרסיביות גוברת, כוחות צבאיים ומבצעיים במזרח התיכון, סמוך לגבולנו מאי פעם, בזירה הלבנונית והסורית כאחד. איראן ממשיכה לתמוך בארגוני הטרור, בחיזבאללה, ולאחרונה ביתר סט בחמאס. איראן ממשיכה להעביר נשק מתקדם ומדויק לארגוני הטרור ולתוך הזירה שלנו.
While Israel continues to point to Iran's ongoing aggressive conduct, the team of negotiators behind the nuclear agreement with the Islamic Republic, which was reached in 2015, have been announced as possible contenders for this year's Nobel Peace Prize. The landmark agreement aimed at limiting the Islamic Republic's nuclear program in exchange for international sanctions relief. However, while the agreement was declared as a political triumph for both the former U.S. President Barack Obama and Iran's President Hassan Rouhani, international watchdogs continue to cite flaws in the deal that has separated Tehran's aggressive policies from its dangerous aspiration of acquiring nuclear weapons capabilities. Thank you for watching us. You can also watch us at TV7IsraelNews.com or TV7.fi. For any comments, please send your emails to IsraelNews@TV7.fi. For more updates from Israel and the region, please join our Facebook page at TV7 Israel News. Praying for the peace of Israel and the peace of Jerusalem. I'm Jonathan Hassan. Have a Erev Tov, and we will see you again tomorrow at the same time.
In order to donate to TV7 Israel News, please follow these simple steps. First, press the Donate logo, located at the bottom left side of TV7 Israel News Facebook page, or on the Donate tab at the head of the page. Then insert the amount you'd like to donate, and fill in your credit card information. Just like this. And press Review Donation and Continue. After reviewing your donation details, please press Donate to finalize your donation. That's it! Your donation is now complete, and an email with your donation details has been sent to your email address. You can also print your donation receipt by pressing the link here. Thank you for supporting TV7 Israel News.